A solid disk of radius r rolls without slipping on a horizontal floor with angular velocity omega and angular acceleration alpha. The magnitude of the acceleration of the point of contact on the disk is option A, 0, option B, r alpha, option C, root of r alpha square plus r omega square whole square, option D, r omega square. Now, answer is, rolling is combined rotation and translation. For example, the wheel of moving car or a bicycle. By the time the wheel completes a full rotation, its center of mass moves through a distance 2 pi r. This is called pure rolling. If wheel moves less than or greater than 2 pi r in one full rotation, slipping occurs at the point of contact. And in this case, frictional force plays an important role. Now, in the given question, they have mentioned the solid disk is rolling without slipping. So, it is a pure rolling. A solid disk of radius r is rolling with an angular velocity omega and angular acceleration alpha. Let us say the point where the disk is in contact with the base is A and the center of the disk is B and the topmost point of the disk is C. In this case, angular velocity at point A means where the disk is coming in contact with the base is equal to 0, and at point B, that is at the center of the disk, it is r omega, and at the C, that is at the topmost point, it is equal to 2 r omega. Now, the angular acceleration at the point A is resultant of tangential acceleration and circumferential acceleration, that is equal to root of at square plus AC square, where AT is the tangential acceleration and AC is the circumferential acceleration. But we know AT is equal to R alpha and AC is equal to R omega square. So, the resultant acceleration is equal to root of R alpha whole square plus R omega square whole square. So, the correct answer is option C, root of r alpha whole square plus r omega square whole square.